Hello and welcome to Nikolai's Genetics Lessons. And today I have prepared an interesting population genetics problem for you. And here's a problem. In a population in Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium, what will be the proportion of marriages between homozygotes? So what kind of marriages we would call homozygous marriages or matings? And this is going to be when someone who is homozygous dominant would mate with another individual who is also homozygous dominant. Second variant would be when someone who is homozygous recessive would mate with another individual who is going to be homozygous recessive. And the third variant would be when someone who is homozygous dominant would mate with someone who is homozygous recessive. So these three type of matings we would call homozygous matings, whether it can be of the same type two homozygotes, like in these two examples, or when homozygous dominant would mate with homozygous recessive. And now let me remind you a Hardy-Weinberg formula, which is frequency of the three genotypes that can be made by two alleles in the gene pool would equal to p squared plus 2pq plus q squared. And if we combine all three genotypes, we are going to get 1 or 100%. And in this formula, p squared stands for the homozygous dominant genotype, so capital A here. 2pq stands for the heterozygous genotype, so capital A and small a here. And q squared stands for the homozygous recessive genotype. So how we are going to find all these combinations? And this is actually very easy. We just have to build a Punnett square. So p squared here, 2pq here, and q squared would go here. So we are going to build a Punnett square in order to find all the possible combinations of these three genotypes. So what all the possible variants of matings we are going to get here. And the first variant would be p squared and p squared. In other words, this is going to be probability of the mating of homozygous dominant genotype with another homozygous dominant genotype. In other words, we can say this is going to be probability of allele A multiplied by probability of allele A also dominant, multiplied by probability of allele A dominant, and multiplied by probability of A dominant. So we are going to get A in a power of 4. So this is going to be frequency of this genotype, so frequency of this mating. And now let's find what we're going to have in other cells. So here we are going to have p squared multiplied by 2pq and p squared multiplied by q squared here and p squared multiplied by 2pq here and 2pq multiplied by 2pq here and q squared multiplied by 2pq here. So also we are going to have p squared multiplied by q squared here and 2pq here multiplied by q squared and q squared multiplied by q squared. And here this mating represent homozygous recessive mating with homozygous recessive. Once again, small a, small a, small a, small a. So if we multiply a by itself four times, we are going to get a small in the power of 4. And now we have found probability of the mating of the homozygous dominant genotype with homozygous dominant genotype. We have found probability of mating of homozygous recessive genotype with homozygous recessive genotype. And now let's find probability of mating of homozygous dominant with homozygous recessive. So we have P squared here, that stands for the homozygous dominant genotype, and Q squared, that stands for the homozygous recessive genotype. So capital A here. And this is going to be the cell, so capital A here, and small a here. So this is going to be one variant, but we also would have another cell. And here we have capital A here, and small a here. So this is going to be second variant. That means that we have two multiplied by P squared and multiplied by Q squared. Once again, P squared, Q squared, P squared, Q squared. So this 2 here stands for 2 cells here. So we have to multiply by 2 to reflect double probability of such a mating. And what we have? We have probability of the mating of homozygous dominant with homozygous dominant, which equals to a in the power of 4, plus we have probability of mating of homozygous recessive genotype with homozygous recessive genotype, which would equal to a small in the power of 4, plus double probability of the mating of the homozygous dominant with homozygous recessive. So let's check our answers, and as you see, this is going to be our answer today. And as you see, this is answer D. I hope this information would be helpful for you on your exam. And this is all for today. Thank you for your attention. Please subscribe for my new videos that I post almost every day. Thumbs up if you like this video. Please write your comments, questions if you have any. Share this video with your classmates. And see you in the next video. Goodbye.